dudes as well as the dudettes. What's going on? This is Becker. Welcome to the second video in the Q&A series. And last time someone suggested that I should actually play the video game while talking. It's going to be a challenge because I'm going to be murdering a lot of things. But if you're interested in... million dollar businesses, talk about Chad from The Bachelorette, Star Wars, whatever you want to talk about, cars, etc. I'm going to be answering all the questions you ask me on Instagram. So stay tuned. It's going to be on a scale of like 10-10. It's going to be like a 10 in neatness. All right, guys, let's get this going. If you do not know, every now and then I like to upload these Q&A videos and using this kind of like video game format because it's easier for me to answer. It's entertaining for you. And we get to murder things together. I feel that really builds a very strong relationship between us. Okay, so don't tell anybody. We can keep doing it together. Anyways, that got weird. If you want to ask me questions about my multi-million-dollar businesses, about Pokemon, whatever, just hit me up on my Instagram. There's just linked above, and we'll be answering them in these videos and Snapchat. So let's just get straight into the questions, okay? Continuing where we left off last week. First question, very important question that I think you guys need to know. Ryan Ellis asked me, dude, why are you not yoked? And my response to that is, I feel like I'm pretty yoked, man. I mean, are you yoked? I challenge you, Ryan Ellis, to go on my Instagram and post a picture of you with your shirt off. In fact, all of my viewers, I think what you need to do immediately, right? Because I will post a picture of myself flexing in the mirror if you do. So Ryan, you do it first, and I'll show you how yoked I am. And then everybody who's watching this, we should just all go on Instagram and post pictures of each other with our shirts off, and we will have, by far, the gayest Instagram on all of Instagram. It'll be great. Okay, it'll be like a pool party just for dudes, because we only have like 3 chicks to watch this. All right, another person asks right here, Alex. Actually, 2 people ask, you know, Alex, how do I stay focused? What's a way to stay focused and actually start my business and care a lot about? And a few other people ask, how do I stop being such a lazy fuck? And I have an answer for you, okay? The reason why we do anything is emotions, okay? And the easiest way to go... and start your business. The reason why you're lazy when you're first trying to start your business or anything like that is because you don't really want it and you don't really believe you can get it. Okay? So I talk about video games all the time and how it's a lot like building a business, and someone else asked that question here. I'm actually answering 4 questions at the same time. All right? Multitasking the fuck out of it. Be impressed. Because someone also asked, you know, what's the best way or how is it in your book when you compared video games to business? So we're going to answer all 3 at the same time. Okay? If you see when people play like World of Warcraft and stuff, you're going to see a lot of people who have really never accomplished anything in your life. And we're about to go murder some people. Just hold up. We're just here for that. We got some fun stuff coming away. But a lot of people who play World of Warcraft have never accomplished anything in their life. And I'm not saying people that play World of Warcraft are there's anything wrong with them. But you're going to see a lot of people that have trouble starting a business, holding a job, be able to dedicate hundreds of hours of focus to World of Warcraft. And if you focus like that on anything, you're going to become very good at it. Very good at it, okay? If you spend 100 hours playing guitar, you're gonna kill it, okay? And I'm all out of aluminum. Shit, I need aluminum. Okay, start the video back up. I teleport somewhere to go grab some aluminum, and now I'm flying. I totally don't cheat. I totally don't cheat, but I'm doing it for you to speed up the video, okay? So, back at it. So we were talking about WoW and video games and stuff like that. So, you see a lot of people who have trouble focusing and creating passion in their life, spend hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of hours playing WoW. And I always was interested in how people did that, because I, back in the day when I was broke, could devote days. I could play for 24 hours straight doing it. And if you can create that type of passion for building a business, you're going to build a business and you're going to be successful. It's not even a question. So how people get addicted and how people get addicted to success, it's just like in video games. And WoW, they have... the success, when you level up, when you get a reward, at first it happens very quickly, just like a drug. You get a big high out of that, so you get that initial high of that getting that drug, getting that thing in your system, so your body creates those chemicals and make you go, oh, I need to get more of this, all right? So what happens is those rewards and that high you get becomes harder and harder to get in the WoW, but you know it's going to get there, and you get those results so quickly that you're able to stretch it down, you're able to focus on it longer and longer and longer for those delayed results. Making money in a lot of stuff doesn't have that quick release, doesn't have that quick reward. But anyways, I'm rambling. Let's just basically sum it up, okay? The number one way to stop being a lazy fuck and stop being productive is, 1, go for results as fast as possible. Don't try and learn, just throw shit at the wall, all right? You know, like, if this is the wall, just all over it until you get results, because then you're going to get those results, those fast feedback loops. They're going to cause you to create that kind of addiction that allows you to, like, for example, this giant-ass building. I sat here for about 10 hours total on the weekend and built this entire thing, and I had focus the entire time because I was constantly getting those results and being able to look at. So you want to trigger that first immediately. Second thing you want to do is learn how to cause those angry emotions, whether it's your friends, whether it's just like whatever. You have to cause those emotions, your body, to get you pissed off and want to do this. You're not going to want to make money. You're not going to go out there and be forced to get those first results until you actually have those emotions. And the third best advice I can give you is if you look at World of Warcraft, one of the reasons why people are so competitive, I'm about to go kill some stuff in a second. Hold on, all you people that are just here to see me chainsaw people's faces. And wow, people get so addicted and competitive to it, or competitive for it, because there's other people doing it. Most of your friends probably aren't entrepreneurs. Most of your friends aren't entrepreneurs. Most of your friends aren't entrepreneurs. A lot of my friends, the majority of my friends, are all millionaires, all entrepreneurs. If I'm failing and not doing what I'm supposed to be doing, like, I feel stupid. You probably don't have that situation. So go join groups of entrepreneurs and people that want to go out there and kill it, and then go and do that. Okay, you want to create that competitiveness, and that's going to drive, and those three things together are going to really help you stop being a lazy fuck. All right, so just because you're a lazy fuck doesn't mean you're truly lazy fuck. It means you haven't really found the right community to write something to do it. So today, what our mission is, all right, we've been tasked to go and investigate the Augusta Safe House. Shit's not right there. So we're going to travel from here to here. We're learning a whole lot about ourselves and getting an education. Okay, so next question on here. Someone asked, Alex, one second, make sure I've got all my weapons, got my chainsaw, that's the most important thing, I just got this, and yeah, there we go. Alright, let's do this shit. Alright, so someone asked me, Alex, why did you sell your Lamborghini Gallardo? Okay, so if you don't know about me, I've owned a Maserati, I've owned a Lamborghini, I've owned a Ferrari, and I don't really drive, I live in Uptown Dallas, so I usually just kind of go and walk everywhere. So, the reason why I sold that car. Oh, what do we got here? Got some baddies? No, these guys won't bother me right now. Not yet, anyways. But bother other people, though. So, I sold that car mostly because Ferrari 458s are just much better. They're way more comfortable. You can drive them around daily. And a Gallardo is like a, it's like a go-kart with like 500 horsepower. It's not useful for anything except going down the street and going, and then and that's it. But if like you just want to cruise down the street to like Dunkin' Donuts and just like get what do we got over here? Got some baddies. Get away from me. But if you just want to cruise down the street to holy shit. If you just want to cruise down the street to Dunkin' Donuts, it's just not efficient for that. Love this shotgun. So that's exactly why I sold it. Alright, so another person asked, Alex. I have these actually like stored in my head because yesterday I tried to film this video and like I had the game volume turned up so high that I was like, you just heard me like screaming in the background like faintly. I'm like, this is how you make money on the internet. And people were like, this is the worst fucking thing you've ever made ever, Alex. So I'm redoing it today because I love you guys that much. But someone asked, Alex, how do you manage to play so many video games and still manage to run all these businesses, okay? what people need to realize is that money has zero connection to time, all right? Now, I'm not one of those motherfuckers who's going to sit here and be like, man, you just need to work like an hour a week and everything's going to like take care of itself. You're good, man. Just get this freedom lifestyle going. I work a lot, okay? And the reason why I work is because like it's fun for me. But you need to understand, like, when I build businesses, they're built the right way. A business is like a building. Okay, when it's built, it's there. If you have the right people and the right... Don't you sneak up on me, dog. Don't you do that. Fucking dogs. A vicious mongrel has attacked me. It's like Pokemon Go. Except you brutally murder the creatures instead of catching them. Which, that would be a good game, too. If you think about it, Pokemon Go is kind of fucked up. Pokemon, the whole concept. If I walked up to you and I'm like, hey, dude, all right, I got this cool children's game, all right? So we go and kidnap these animals from their homes, and then we just have them fight to death, okay? And they'll, like, make this giant league and, like, we'll just have them kill each other, right? And, like, it'll be super sweet, and then we'll, like, make gems, and then we'll feed them, like, puffin bits, and we'll whenever they get low, we'll inject them with, like, regenerative, like, potions to, like, heal them, and then we'll poison them all the time, too. It's gonna be great, all right? So let's go, I'm gonna go capture this snake, and we're gonna have it fight your dachshund over here. And you'd be like, dude, what the fuck is wrong with you? But I'm like, oh, no, it's Pokemon. And you're like, okay. Okay, cockfighting's cool, as long as it's not for real. That's something I definitely want my kids learning how to do. Mixed messages right there. So, when you build a business, people are like, what the fuck is going on here? This guy's trying to give me advice, and all he does is talk about Pokemon. This channel sucks dick. So, when a business is built, it's like a building. Okay, and it's built properly. You have the right people in the right spot doing the right things. The building doesn't blow up when you walk away. Okay, now if you go build a building out of like toilet paper and toilet paper rolls, and like you have to hold it together, or you like build it like a house of cards, we have to constantly monitor it. Yeah, you don't have time to play video games. You don't have time to do all that kind of stuff. But here's the thing about work, dude. If I put in 40 hours a week, heck, if I put in 100 hours a week, if I have a team of 30 people, those people just put in 1,200 hours of work into my business every single week. No matter even if I work every single hour, every single day, I can never do as much work as if I build a good team. You need to understand that. That's absolutely fucking huge. And you see some people that work like 80-hour weeks, and I'll tell you the truth, dude. The 40 hours I put in are better than the 80. This guy's scared of me. That's why I stuttered. I'm just going to stutter the rest of the video. The 80. What a fucking idiot. Mom shouldn't take long. Anyways, what are they saying? All right, so when you go in, when I put in 40 hours of work a week, it's more effective than the person that's working 8 hours a week, because guess what? I'm rested. I'm focused. I'm happy to be there. I'm passionate. I'm not drained, okay? So when, like, I have, for example, coders, all right? It's been studied so many times, employees are able to get so much work done when they work 40 or even 30-hour work weeks versus working an 80-hour work week. Because what happens when you work a 60-hour work week, when you work an 80-hour work week, one, you lose focus and passion. So you're not thinking creatively, right? You only have so much creative chemicals in your heads where you can come up with great ideas. You need to understand, like, there's literally a chemical in our brain, forgot what it fucking is. I also forgot where the fuck I'm going, all right? But there's a chemical in our brain that literally over time goes away, and it literally controls how much we can focus, how creative we are. So that runs out. You have to restore that by sleeping, by resting, by not focusing, by just like doing this, murdering zombies in the streets, okay? So look, when I put in those 40 hours, I'm completely rested. And the person that's going out and working 80 hours a week, those 40 extra hours he works, guess what? There's a lot of mistakes that happen. There's a lot of things that aren't done well. And what happens at the end of the day is the business is not put together well enough. The business ends up depending too much on one person. The business ends up having a lot of errors in it that you have to go back later on and fix again. I can't tell you how many times when I used to work 60, 80-hour weeks all the time, I'd have to go back and fix shit all the time because I was constantly fucking stuff up and stuff was constantly slapped together because I was overworked, overstressed, and it just wasn't good for anybody, including my customers, okay? So I'm not saying don't work 80-hour week, don't work hard, all right? I'm not saying that at all. Where's this fucking door? Trying to get momentum going in this game. Don't stop working hard, but also realize you need to rest, okay? You need to build a proper team. Door, where are you? Demand you reveal yourself. So yeah, just take that to heart next time you're thinking about doing that. So, next question, right? And also, I play a lot of video games because I want to start a video game company. So this is like technically research, or at least that's what I'm going to keep telling myself. All right. Someone said, Alex, come to NYC. I'll show you the nightlife, bro. All right, just the fact that you called me bro makes me instantly not like you. But let's forget you did that, bro. Buddy old pal. Actually, I'm doing the same thing. I call people buddy old pal, so I must seem like a dick. Anyways, all right, bro. I'm actually going to stop filming this video right now. Actually, it is 6 o'clock on a Wednesday, I think. I don't know what time it is. But at 9 o'clock, I'm cutting this off. I'm flying to NYC, bro. I'm getting a handle of cheap Taka vodka. All right, I'm talking the $8 stuff. The shit that makes you die when you wake up in the morning. And we're gonna party, bro. It's going to be great. Actually, I did go out in New York City one time with my... Oh, don't, no one's there. No one's there. Shh. It's what I call stealth right there. Solid snake. I did go out in New York City one time with my mentor, Khan Mirza. And he's worth like 5 or million. So you would have like thought like, man, we had like the craziest night ever. But in reality, it just ended up like... All the bars, ooh, this is a tough raider right here. All the bars in Dallas. Yes, I will totally take your switch flag. All the bars in Dallas close at 2 a.m. So around like 3 a.m. when all the bars close. There we go. So all the bars close at 2 a.m. in Dallas. And so by like around 3 a.m. in New York, I was just literally like asleep on the couch while everybody else was partying. I wasn't passed out. Okay. I wasn't passed out. I was literally just sleeping there. So, I'm not that fun to go out with, bro. So, there you go. So, another person right here asks, where's my chainsaw? Let's test this thing out. There we go. So, another person asks, Alex, what is your advice for teens? This is a very underwhelming chainsaw. I feel like it'd be a lot worse than this. Yeah, that's what you get! Fear my chainsaw of death! This is like a... I feel like I'm attacking a person with like a glue gun or something. It's just not effective. Back to the Doom shotgun. Stone said, what's your best advice for teens? Well, if you're not gonna be specific, I'm just gonna be an ass about it. If you're a teen, step number one to making money, stay away from creepy guys in vans. Don't do that, alright? That's guaranteed way not to make money, okay? If you're a teen, don't mix liquor and beer together, okay? That's a bad way to not make money, all right? You will throw up everywhere, okay? If you were a teen, you need to know and take one lesson in life. Thou who smelt it probably dealt it, all right? So that's my advice if you're a teen. Stay away from creepy people in vans, okay? Don't mix liquor and beer in the same night, okay? Especially... do not eat spicy food and then drink liquor and beer on the same night. You will have horrible things happen to your body and on the outside of your body. And three, thou who smelt it, dealt it. If you're going to ask me questions, you better be specific or I'm going to have fun with it, okay? Because what else do I have to do? All right, so someone asked me, should I get an MBA? Someone hiding up there. I get this question a lot, okay? So a lot of people think, there you go. So, a lot of times people ask me, you know, Alex, should I go to school? Should I get a bachelor's degree? Should I go to college? And I just want to put, like, a situation in front of you, because, like, I tell you guys this shit all the time, and then you, like, argue with me, like, I want to go to college and live the college lifestyle. There's no other way to meet girls and get drunk at parties, unless I go get, and join a frat, and wear a polo, and short shorts, and say bro and dude a lot. There's no other way, Alex. I need to go to college. Fuck business. So where's this elevator even gonna take me? This only takes me like one floor. Okay, there we go. We're going up, so that's good. Alright, so. Look, I'm gonna give you a riddle. Let's imagine I left the Air Force, I think like, I don't know, 5 years ago? Yeah, 5 years ago. So, riddle me this, and you tell me what I should have done. Stupid thing. So look. I get out of the Air Force, and I'm like, you know what? There's these people online. They're making money. Okay, and that's how I actually got my start. I met some people on a forum who were doing SEO, and I was like, hey, man, how you doing that? What's going on over there? How you making that money? You playing video games all day, but you're making money. There's this, like, a little French guy who made, like, $500 a day, and he was such a dick, and he just talked down to everybody, but he had, like, a friend who would actually, like, help people. And so that's how I got Bad Dog! Bad Dog! This is why Boots is such a good dog. I don't beat my dog. Anyways, so imagine I just got out of the Air Force. And I decide, man, you know what? There's people making money on the internet, but you know what? Fuck it. I need to go and live the college lifestyle, okay? I'm going to go to college. I would have been graduating in the past year. Okay, and right now as I make this video, instead of making $4 million a year like I do now, hopefully going on to make $1 million a month in the next few months as we release Conquer and Market Hero, cross my fingers, hope to die, Instead of making that amount of money, I'd be struggling to make 50K a year right now. And you know what's even worse? I would have wasted 4 years of my life. 4 years. Now, the problem I have with college is not so much the experience. It's not so much what you learn. The problem with what you learn in college is that you learn a lot of broad information. And to make money, you're a rookie. Dick. Now, the thing about college is you learn a bunch of broad information. Broad information doesn't help you make money. If you know a little bit about every single martial art there is in the world, you're a master of nothing. You're a master of nothing. I'm trying to say insightful things, a person who knows a little bit about a lot of things is not going to do much, all right? And that's what college teaches you. That's all it teaches you. Even the business degrees, even the masters, you learn a lot about a few things. You learn a lot about a lot of things. When I got to $1 million a year, I was really good at SEO. I was really good at selling SEO. That was it. If you want to make $1 million selling real estate, you don't need to know math. You don't need to know how to make an Excel spreadsheet work. I think there's like a death claw down here. Let's keep this interesting. You don't need to know how to make a spreadsheet. Hello. I like how the only games I play are just huge, violent, morbid games. You guys must think I'm just some sick fuck. But yeah, if you want to be good at real estate, you don't need to know how to make an Excel spreadsheet. You don't need to know how to manage your budget and... oh, shit. Well, that was underwhelming. Deathclaw! Even downloaded a mod to make you guys stronger. All you need to do to be good at real estate is be really fucking good at selling houses. That's insufficient power? Where's the power off? It's because I unplugged this? Oh, there we go. Turn that on. You need to be good at one and only one thing. Selling houses. That's it. Don't need a college degree. Don't need to know anything else. You just need to be really good at getting people on the phone or at whatever your method is and selling a fucking house. That's it. And you know how long it takes to get really good at selling if you focus on it? About a month and a half. 2 months. Okay? I learned how to copyright in the span of really well in the span of about 6 months. Okay? And that got me to $1 million a year. I challenge you to find any fucking college education where you can make $1 million a year within your first year of doing something. Okay? It took me about a year and a half to get to like six figures a year. And then about at my 2 year mark, that's when I was making about $1 million a year doing all the internet stuff. And I don't just do internet stuff. I just build businesses. This could be offline or online. So that's the big kicker right there. And the thing is, when you go to college, you waste four fucking years. Four fucking years of your life. When you could go, if you want to live the college lifestyle, just go fucking move to a college town, party your ass off with your friends, and when they're in school, taking their fucking pointless test, and like being like, oh man, college sucks, I'm in debt like $50,000, and all I've learned how to do is use Microsoft Excel, you'll be like, oh, that's funny, I sat around, got drunk all the time, and learned how to do services for businesses, or open Shopify stores and run Shopify ads, and now I make, hello. I'm not going to be happy about that. I know how to make Shopify stores. I can run Facebook ads. I can build software and all sorts of other shit like that too, okay? So that's what you can do. That is what you can do. Or you can go to college and actually learn. If you're a badass, you go to college and... there's one thing I hate, it's mole rats. You go to college at the same time while learning how to do internet marketing, and you could be a real badass, all right? You could have the whole PhD so you can tell everybody and hang it on your wall and then actually know how to make money too, which is really rare. Oh my god. I will go this way instead. Okay, so that's kind of the answer to that question. So let's see what other questions we got. All right, so Michael asks, Alex, what do you think about Kim Jong-un? What's going on over here? All right, time to go Solid Snake. So much for that headshot. Alex, what do you think of Kim Jong-un? And frankly, you know, look, there's two parts to this question. All right, first, there's like my realistic, like politically correct side. Obviously, Kim Jong-un does really bad shit, okay? But let's look at it from a comical side, because look, we like to have fun here, right? We're talking about a guy whose mortal enemy is the guy who does Gundam style. Okay, this is like a guy that sits in his castle with his designer glasses on, playing video games, and hanging out with Dennis Rodman, and plotting ways to destroy PSY or whatever his name is, okay? This guy gets This is a guy who, a country leader, whose biggest problem is Seth Rogen is too mean of him, or too mean and makes mean jokes about him in a movie. It's funny. It's weird. And then, like, everybody in the country is like, you know what? That motherfucker up there, wearing that his pajamas everywhere, and wearing, designer sunglasses twice the size of his head, while listening to, what's her name? Taylor Swift. That's the guy who we need to lead us, okay? There's everything lines up in this situation. Everything lines up. It's weird. It's also kind of funny. So, that's the comical view. I'm sure a lot of people will be like, Alex Becker thinks that tyrant is funny, and he's a big old dick, and he hates women, and gay people, and blacks, and Chinese people, and white people, and Jews. He's just a racist, dirty asshole. And there we go. Just lost all reviews. We're just gonna. Who do you think's gonna win? I'm not gonna shoot anyone right here. Who's gonna win? I'm betting on the green guys. We're just beating this man to death with a hammer. Okay, the green guys definitely won. So I'm gonna head back to the base. I think we've murdered enough things, and we completed our mission. So that's kind of cool, don't you think? So, last questions while I run up and get this going. Okay. So, someone says, is it possible to get into software with no experience in coding and only basic computing skills? Yeah, it totally is. Now look, unlike a lot of ways to make money online, and a lot of people tell you, starting a software business is brutal, okay? For the past 3 years, I've made a substantial amount of money doing software, but I'm also going to say I've almost failed more than I've succeeded in software. I've lost a lot of money, and I've been kicked in the nuts a lot of times, okay? A lot of times, just like that. Like, that's like my life every single day, is just getting shot with one of these shotguns. And I eventually have it kind of figured out to the point. And it's a business model. It doesn't have to do anything with computing, okay? Like, I don't know code, and I shouldn't know code, because my job as the leader of a company is not to code. It's to make sure all my employees are super happy, and that I attract the best coders in the world. Even if you're an amazing coder, as soon as your company starts growing, your job isn't coding, okay? Your job is making sure you attract the best coders, you keep your best coders, and you attract amazing people to work for your company, and you make them happy, and you keep them working at their top performance. If you want to have a successful business, you attract amazing people, and you keep amazing people. That's your only job as a CEO, and after that, your job is making sure the company has money and signing the bills and getting kicked in the teeth every single time there's a problem. That's your job as CEO, okay? So, yeah, you can totally get into it without computing skills or anything like that. Now, look, if you're like 15, 16, learn fucking code, okay? Because it's so helpful when you start off if you can just make code and start your own business for free, okay? Get 1 to 2 years underneath your belt while you're learning about internet business and stuff like that. Stupid freaking helicopter! These things, like, don't die. I put a mod on, so we're gonna get this guy. We're gonna get this guy. I'm turning on none of that ammo right now. We're gonna kill this motherfucker. That's right! That's right! You too. So what are we talking about? Oh yeah, coding, developing, so. If you wanna get good at, yeah, totally learn code. It's totally worth something to learn, especially if you're young, okay? You can also get into the computing business just by partnering with a developer, giving him 50% of the company. You handle the sales and stuff like that. But handling sales and everything is a whole skill set on its own, okay? It's just as difficult as coding in its own regard. They're both different skill sets. So, yeah, you can totally, totally do it. My advice is learn code, but also get started in some of the lower cash flow areas of making money on the internet. Shopify, SEO, Gearbubble stuff is just really good right now. That's just stuff that's working. If you know how to run advertising and stuff like that, you're never going to be poor, because that's just a skill set that's always going to be great online. If you know how to spend $1 and make $2 back, you'll never be poor. There might not be a Facebook, there might not be a Google, but there will always be somebody selling traffic or selling advertising. It's going to be like that till the end of time, or until people stop selling stuff. Yeah. So that's what I was just getting into. Software the past few years has been very difficult for me. I've definitely failed and gotten in more trouble than I have succeeded. Now, of course, I've had some big successes too, successes that fund me and stuff like that. I've had out-of-nowhere successes as well with software. But it really came down to luck because I was still learning it. All right, it took me about 3 years to really get it down. And like Conker and Market Hero, like actually the first software I've ever made, and I'm like super duper proud of. All right, I've made other software in the past that I'm like happy about. They're good software, but this is like top of the notch shit. So it took me a while to kind of get there. So that's what I would suggest to you. So that being said, guys, if you enjoy this kind of stuff, if you like watching me murder people while answering questions about businesses and Kim Jong-un, which is much more important, then, oh crap, I can't get to my elevator door. Shit, if you enjoy this kind of stuff, then what you should do is you should go and subscribe right now. And then what you should do is also follow me on Instagram, where I run these Q&As, and then I answer all the questions in these Q&As on this channel. It's amazing. You should tell your mom about it. Just call on the phone right now and be like, Mom, this guy just made fun of Kim Jong-un and thought he was funny. He's a horrible person. And that's all there really is. Then subscribe to this channel. And also follow me on Snapchat, because I answer questions on there as well. As well as take videos of my dog and the food I eat. Overall, it's a great way to spend your time. Just like building giant, big-ass buildings. Have you guys seen this thing? It's pretty cool. So, that being said, guys, I'm going to wrap up the video while kind of hovering away from my giant super tower. This is really, like, the only thing I've ever accomplished in my life. Like, the businesses are cool, but, like, that's neat. That's neat. So, with that being said, guys, that's all I got. I'll see you in the next video.
Everything changes.
Bye. Actually, Illuminati HQ over here. Jay-Z, that's his house right there. All right, and Beyonce lives there because they aren't doing so hot right now. So, just wanted to pull back the veil and let you guys know what's really going on.